Welcome back to the Roadshow. This morning in the buzz, a huge crowd is expected at tonight's town council meeting in West Warwick, where the school committee has cut all sports and other after-school activities from its budget. School committee says they had no other choice because of budget cuts. Last night, hundreds of parents, teachers, and coaches gathered in the school's auditorium for an informal meeting to voice their concerns over the axing of all after-school activity. That includes clubs, rallies, band, all high school and middle school sports, and anything else that happens after school hours. Those eliminations come in the wake of a recent 5% budget cut made by the West Warwick Town Council. Cut has already been made and will go into effect next year. Take a listen to what some of the people had to say at the meeting last night about the cuts.
My freshman is in band, and I'm just worried that something that she's liked all throughout since she was younger is being taken away from her, and I can't stand for that.
I want to play football. It's what I wanted to do as soon as I entered high school. That's stuff you do in high school. You don't just sit down, do homework, do work, and go home. It's high school experience.
And with the crowd expected to be much larger than usual, town council meeting will actually be moved to West Warwick High School tonight. So what do you guys think about this, this whole thing? It's sad that it's come to this in the, in West Warwick.
I completely agree. I think sad is the appropriate word. I think that there's so many emotions going on, and, you know, everyone wants to point fingers and blame everyone else. And what it truly is it's sad for our students.
Yeah.
And it's sad for these kids to be missing out on, just like that young man was saying, these opportunities that they look forward to and they think are part of their high school experience.
I am devastated, to be honest. I mean, especially because this really hits home for me a lot, mm-hmm. because I'm from East Providence and they're kind of going through the same thing.
Yeah.
They already cut middle school sports and we're trying to, you know, get that back. And to me, I know many people watching this are going, yeah, you know, you played sports, but that was a big part of my life.
Yeah.
After school, no matter what kind of level it was, no matter what activity, that was a drive for me to also go to school.
Yes.
Sure.
And it wasn't just the fact that, you know, it's not about the trophies and the awards and the wins and losses.
Mm-hmm.
I couldn't tell you a record of any sport that I played looking back
mm-hmm.
on it. But what I can tell you is the life lessons that you learn through activities, through clubs, through the, whether it's the band or whether you're playing sports, whatever it is, it's the interaction, it's teamwork, it's, you know, learning how to play together, learning how to win, learning how to
mm-hmm.
lose, you know, that drive, that
it's
determination, that perseverance,
yeah.
that work ethic that you gain from any sort of after-school activity is so crucial, and you're going to carry that on into the rest of your life. Exactly what that young man said, it's not all about going to school and doing homework and then you leave.
Yeah, there's so many other things. I mean, like you were saying, you know, I mean, you played sports, you were a teacher in school. I mean, you know what these kids, you know, expect after school. And,
yes.
you know, it first of all these programs after school are to keep a lot of these kids out of trouble. Some of these kids
yeah.
may not have places to go after
mm-hmm.
school. So it's not so much like a babysitting, but it's, you know, it's camaraderie with other kids that they go to school with. And it's all part of the, you know, the high school experience. I mean, you
yeah.
go to high school, you want to play sports, you want to, you know, be in
mm-hmm.
a band
or
music. These are the things that you remember that you know
mm-hmm.
you take with you after you get out of high school, go on to college, and then
yeah.
just, you know,
well, speaking
regular
about
life.
Going on to college, I mean, you think about that. Granted, it's what you look back on and you find the most fonding,
mm-hmm.
but now these kids are going to have a disadvantage applying to college.
Sure.
So much about what we're being told is it's not just about your grades, it's not just about your
right.
SATs.
Well-rounded.
You need to be well-rounded.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And now these kids are going to have a serious disadvantage in the field when they try to apply to colleges.
And I think, too, this touches upon a lot of different things. Like you said, you know, being well-rounded, that's, of
mm-hmm.
course, going to get you to that next level. But look at, you know, even just childhood obesity, for one.
Mm-hmm.
You're telling me that you're not giving them an outlet to just go run around and you know, be active and expand, you know,
yeah.
not only their minds, but, you know, their bodies,
sure.
too, and just be working towards a goal. I mean, I think
yeah.
that's really the lesson there. It doesn't matter how good you are at,
mm-hmm.
at a club or at an instrument or a sport or something like that. It's just having those goals and setting them for yourself.
Correct. Well, I think no matter what, you know, if you're passionate about this, whether you live in West Warwick or not,
mm-hmm.
you should definitely show up to the town meeting because, hey, we do live in America, and I know that originally this budget was voted on. It's going against what was voted on, so go and voice your concerns. So concerns are being voiced everywhere, including Facebook,
mm-hmm.
believe it or not. And we asked our friends up there to see what they thought, and Marie Terrell says academics should be first and foremost. Sports and extracurricular activities can be found through local town recreation programs. And Jay Devani says this is shameful. They should be audited. Let's see where every penny is actually going. Also on Facebook, Ginny Urana Falcone says the state raises sugar and soda beverages tax to help stop obesity, and then we take after-school activities away. It's backwards, if you ask me. I completely agree with that.
So many great points being said today.
We have Twitter weighing in. SJH96 says kids need sports. They help kids in so many ways. They learn a lot and keep them active and out of trouble.
Very true.